I'm on a radio.
Yeah, fuck your dreams, nigga. This reality.
Shout out Puff Daddy.
They say I'm he knocking on the door, don't let the devil in.
Shout out the devil, don't let him in. Ramona Radio. How's everybody feeling today?
Feeling great.
It's a beautiful feeling. Greatness is great.
It is.
It's a sunny day. We on the tail end of the heat wave. It's still kind of hot, but you know, we on the tail end of the heat wave. Everything is going good. I'm finna learn how to use my irrigation system. It's just all, everything is looking up.
You got a moat?
Nah. Ooh, that's a good idea though.
Should build a moat.
Matter of fact, I might just build like a trap, like a Vietnamese, like, oh, don't step on that leaf. Trap.
You feel me? Oh, right. You just like fall into a hole. Or they get you put in a cage made of sticks.
Cage made of sticks. You feel me? Maybe a puppy. Who knows, man? 2020 is throwing me for a loop. My creativity is at its peak. I'm ready for some water torture, some waterboarding. You feel me?
Mm-hmm.
The gym is overrated. The other day, I figured out you can buy a weight bench yourself.
Absolutely.
You don't need a license or none of that. So that you know what that's gonna lead to. Remember the perfect push-up?
I do.
Shout out that man. Shout out.
That guy's a veteran.
Yeah, man. Shout out Bowflex.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out Tybo.
Yup.
Shout out the lap band surgery.
Shout out Dr. Miami.
Yeah, man. Just shout out everything fitness. Shout out because, you know, Dr. Miami, that counts as fitness. It's probably hot in here.
It shout is out office? Every.
Yeah, hold on. Let me check if they got Groupon. So Dr. Miami himself doesn't have Groupon, but you can get a plastic surgery in Miami Groupon. Coral Metastatics for non-surgical eye lift for crow's feet, brows, and under the eyes. They have a deal for that. But Fabio Castro MD Artistic Plastic Surgery. That's just for eyebrows and eyelash treatment. That's just a threading with the tint. Oh, Ernest DiGermino. No, excuse me, Ernest DiGeronimo.
Yo.
He's giving away 20 units of Eximen for $149.
The fuck is Eximen?
She got, wow. He also has 20 units of Botox for $159. That's 36% off.
He's trapping.
Shout out deals, man. I love a good deal.
Shout out deals.
Did you run into any deals this week?
I don't think so.
Yeah, me neither.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Deals are kind of anti-black, if you want to be honest, unless it's like a deal from the district attorney. And those are bad deals.
Nah, how is it anti-black?
When the last time you really got a good deal while being black?
That usually happens, bro. I'm not like just out here getting jibbed all day.
But like, even if like a deal's usually like, hey man, this toaster oven is hot, like I'm gonna need you to get this off of me and I give it to you for the low. That's not really a deal.
Why not? Because the dude stole it and he's making full profit or what?
Just because like it's like a we helping each other thing, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
which I'm cool with too. But it's not like it's not just a translucent deal. It's not like a, hey, out the kindness of my heart, here's 45% off.
Yeah, that, I don't know. People would be scared of that. That sounds like socialism.
And that's what I'm saying, because we have so much trauma as black people that if somebody just trying to help us out, it's got to be a string on that thing. You get what I'm saying?
Yep.
Shout out Black America. Shout out Black Rob. Shout out Loon, Free Loon, he's home. Shout out Killer Cam, I saw him freestyling in the park. He's home.
Yeah, he was linked up on the whip, talking that shit. He was running his mouth.
Yeah, he was talking big jargon.
Yeah,
Shout out, I don't know who else to shout out.
Shout out Jewels, he back, you feel me?
Jewels, he's back. Did he always have those teeth?
No.
Shout out Jewels for the new teeth then. Before I shouted out the new teeth, I wanted to make sure it was like a, you know.
It's new teeth.
I don't have a problem with new teeth. The internet seems to think I have a problem with new teeth, but I support new teeth.
Did you call Joe Budden Chief Teeth?
Nah, that wasn't me. But I'm not mad at that.
Yeah, that was a good one.
Everybody got new teeth now. Except me. I keep it pretty organic. Rest in peace, Trader Joe. Once more times. I thought about that the other day. He got to live a full life. It's probably because he's white, but who knows? Ramona Radio. Shout out to whole Harlem. So the trust is where we keep the 40 cows hitting. Double park with my hat. Shout out to Harlem 30s. Prayers going up for Jacob Blake and his family. You know, all that good stuff.
Absolutely.
Fuck the police and all that good stuff.
All of them.
What's the little white boy with the chopper?
Yeah, whatever the fuck his name is.
Yeah, fuck his name.
Henderson.
Fuck Henderson and his mom.
Yeah.
And Henderson's granny. Fuck
yeah.
Her. NBA players quit. Now they playing again.
Basketball's. Oh, wait, are they playing again?
You know them niggas playing again, man.
That's tough.
Come on.
That's tough. I thought we was about to get some real protest activity, bro, but. You know, Clippers and six, I guess.
Yeah, I guess. Oh, man. A couple people got swept this week. The Philadelphia 76ers got swept.
Are they cursed?
I'm going to tell you how I feel, right? They'll never succeed because they never acknowledge Beanie Siegel and Freeway. Think about it. What they did
Explain
to
Explain that.
No. Listen, think about it.
All right.
Nipsey got the courtside seats, right?
Yep.
Now, I'm pretty sure that Beanie Siegel's been courtside before at one of those games. But I didn't see him on the camera. And then they did that to Allen Iverson. I've never seen Hollow Man courtside at a Sixers game. I never seen Reed Dallas courtside at a Sixers game. I never seen Cicero courtside at a Sixers game. Excuse me, I'm still getting over something in the pain in my voice as I say this. I just never seen the legends. I never seen Emilio or Sparks.
I would make a good bet that Beanie Siegel's probably sat at more Knicks games courtside than Sixers games.
And that's a problem. Shout out New York for embracing hip hop always, unless it's from California or the South. But shout out to y'all. Who else is out the playoffs?
Oh, wait. So back to the people leaving Philadelphia when we talked about Uzi, Jimmy Butler, and everybody else. We had to add Markel Fultz to that conversation.
Markel Fultz left and start getting consistent on him.
Yeah, that boy played dead. Went to Orlando, tax-free living. Now he's fucking god body.
You know what's crazy about Markel Fultz? He's a bust, and he averages like 5 less points than Ben Simmons, and he got a max. But hey, who am I? What do I know? I don't really like Ben Simmons. I'm going to be real with you.
Would you let Ben Simmons call you the N-word?
Hell no. I'll let Young Dirt from Hard Times call me the N-word before I let Ben Simmons call me the N-word.
Yeah, I have. Sadly, I agree with that.
You feel me?
Yeah, I had this conversation with Uzi last week, too. It was just like, just out of nowhere, I was just like, hey, would you let Michael Porter Jr. say the N-word around you? And he said, absolutely not. And I feel the same.
It's gonna be such a horrible like phrasing of it too.
Yeah. It's gonna feel like you're on Call of Duty, and I'm not on that.
Then I told him, nigga. It's gonna be like one of those.
It's gonna be extra performative.
Like, nigga.
Right.
Yeah, no. I feel like basketball is like, you can tell which basketball players are black. You get what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
Like, it's a big difference between example A and the Morris twins.
I seen Marcus punch a guy in the face with a basketball after throwing an elbow at his jaw.
Because he was too close.
Yeah, and he looked like YC. That was pretty funny.
And then it's like, they're dirty players. The streets is cold, my friend.
Yeah.
I don't know, man. A lot of blackface in the NBA.
Yeah, this is why Patrick Beverly is one of my favorite players.
And they hate Patrick Beverly.
Yeah, but they can't say shit about Patrick Beverly for real, for real. Because they're not from where he's from.
And my thing is, like, you know, he going, like, Patrick Beverly is what we call a slider. Like, his slider badge is on Hall of Fame. Because Kawhi is like, oh, man, they double teaming me on the elbow. Patrick Beverly, like, you want me to slide? Kawhi probably don't even know what Patrick Beverly is going to do. Neither does Patrick Beverly, but he's ready to slide. And it's like, I've never heard TJ Warren talk, but I'm pretty sure it's not his first time with braids, right? Now,
yeah, not at all. He been at those when Bow Wow was popping.
You feel me? Yeah. Now, seeing like Steph Curry with the braids, it hurts. It rubs me the wrong way.
You're not feeling that?
That's all I'm saying.
With the low cut on the sides, you're not feeling those?
He got the Queen Latifah set it off, so on the top of his head.
I was going to call them R&B braids, but that's same bag.
Shout out Queen Latifah, man.
Always.
Shout out Naughty by Nature.
Jersey.
Shout out New Jersey Twerk. Shout out Sue Surf. Shout out Overrated.
Yeah. Hey, get well soon, Twerk, bro. He got into a car accident. Shit look crazy.
Oh, man. What was he driving like? Like a Ford Taurus?
I have no clue.
He looked like big man, small car. Twerk, we here for you.
Yeah.
Jersey.
Always. Jersey.
That means the round is over, Tyler Page. I'm on the radio.
Yeah.
Smoke free, all of y'all calling out toll free. Label rob you for millions, yet you wanna put a hole in me. Sugar free, season, but I'm salt free. You lay a hand on hold my shoe to shoot for free. I promise World War III. Send an order through a hands free. Kill you in 24 hours or shorter, you can't ignore the hand speed. On guard, it's off the head, this improv, but it's no comedy. Sign I fail, hell nah. Ha ha.
What's free, Westside Ty?
It's a great question.
A base diet is free. This acidity that we put in all our foods, we gotta slow it down. We gotta do better.
It's true. You gotta have the alkaline chart in your kitchen, get right.
I'm thinking about fried chicken Fridays. And that's just the only time that the chicken's fried.
Once a week.
Keeping it real, you know, beautiful. I was sick. I lost about 20 pounds. That's not real, but about 10. Finna get this incline bench. There's too much going on in my life.
Yo. Oh, we got to buy the stand for the punching bag, too.
Oh, yeah.
The Binatown Market.
Shout out Price from Audio Push. He just got the food truck Brody Hannes.
Yes, sir. Hibachi?
Hibachi.
Evil Side Hibachi?
Evil Side Hibachi. I'm looking at it right now. Black-owned hibachi's on the side. Wow, okay. A lot
That menu is short and concise, so you know the food's banging.
Yeah, this is amazing. Wow, is this chef hats on top of afros?
Oh yeah, did they do that?
That's what it looks like.
Put it on a t-shirt price tag.
Shout out him, and shout out all black business, except for black-owned human trafficking. We gotta chill. Leave that to the white people, man.
Yeah, that's out.
Shout out Jamaica. Shout out Jamaica Queens. What else happened this week? Joe Budden leaves Spotify.
I'm loving that. I'm not finished with that episode, but he running his mouth.
I haven't even got around to it, but what I do know is I only got Spotify for the Joe Budden podcast.
Same here.
So with that being said, Can't wait for the transition. That shit expensive, man. Joe Budden, come to Apple Music.
Play all the music you want, bruh.
You see us. This is not a podcast. It's the best radio show in the world.
It's true.
Tom Joyner, how you doing? But it's me.
Yeah, it's our time now, buddy.
Ron Seacrest, how you doing? But it's Ty.
Hey, give it up. Stick to TV.
Stick to TV, sir. Tom Joyner, we love you. Seacrest, don't let us catch you outside. Tom Joyner might drive, but that's enough. You get where I'm going. Again to the 17 row with AK-47 Henderson. I hope you die in jail from staph infection. I know you're 17. I hope you're both your parents getting a fiery car crash as you sit in your cell. And then you get a cellie who makes you get off the top bunk and sleep on the floor because that's where he wants to put his hygiene.
Yeah, hey, Hendo, make room for the dub, my nigga. You on the floor tonight.
Yeah, you on the floor tonight. You're use a bitch. I can't think what else happened this week. Well, screw it. Ramona Radio.
You can't take me on a date that I pay for.
Shout out, date.
If you lose me,
So John Madden came out this week. What's your final?
How was that?
It's Madden.
It's a demo still, right?
Oh no, it's the whole shebang.
Oh, it's the whole game.
But if you've played it in the past 5 years, you've played it.
Gotcha.
What is your fondest Madden memory, Westside High?
Man. About to show my age, but I used to have a Game Gear and I had Madden 96. Yeah, and I used to play that as a little ass kid. It was always Raiders and 49ers because those were the first two teams that popped up as the default, and that was it. You know what I mean? Just spamming sweep routes, running it up.
Sometimes you gotta spam the sweep. I'm happy you said that. That's metaphorical.
Yeah. Yeah, them old games, if you just got the right player and you ran a sweep, you were out of there.
Who do you think our sweep spammers will be in today's NFL game? Now, I'm gonna make a confession before we start. I have no idea who's in the NFL.
I was gonna say the same shit, bro. We need Tyler Page to plug in with this sweep, bro.
Name five people in the NFL.
Wait, what? Odell Beckham.
Yep, your man. Your boy.
Kaepernick. Wait, he's not. Is he in the NFL? Yeah.
He's not in the league. He's not. It's the 4-year anniversary of him taking a kneel, though. That happened.
Beast mode.
Okay, Marshawn.
Let's see.
He's not in the league either, I'm pretty sure.
Well, this is the last time I watched the NFL, so I'm just going off my timeline. I don't know.
So basically none of us know.
Like, I would say Ray Lewis. Like, that's not I know that's not true.
No, come. Tyler.
Yeah, Ray Lewis told, bro.
Did he snitch?
That's the rumor I'm starting.
I mean, he has said some fugazi shit since he got off with the knife crime.
Somebody went to jail.
Man. All right, say that then.
I Googled Game Gear, right?
Yep.
I like the yellow one. Is this a handheld or is it like, what is this?
Absolutely. It was one first. It was Sega's handheld.
Look, man. I don't make all the rules, right? But I've been alive for a long time. Very long time. There's no need for cars to have gas anymore. It's tacky. Other day I saw a gas station and I just it just disgusted me.
Just look at them in there buying hot chips and banging on each other, asking each other where they're from. Disgusting.
You feel me? Like, why are you there?
Yep.
I will promise you, gas has a direct connection to gang crimes in Los Angeles. I'm just putting that out there. Because since I've gotten the Tezzy, I haven't seen one enemy. Actually, I have seen one. I've seen two people from the enemies. One was my friend. The other one was a nice guy. And I was at the gas station. Other than that, it's all been peace and tranquility in my life.
Yep.
Must admit. With that being said, no more fossil fuels. They're killing the economy. They're killing the environment. And they're killing the seals. You didn't hear it here, but you heard it from me. I'm on the radio.
I know caffeine got you compassionate, but it's different.
Shout out white people. I'm just playing. Gotta live with y'all right now. See you later, dude. Ramona Radio.